Welcome back to Breakfast, and get ready to be disgusted. I know it's breakfast time, I'm sorry. Put the cereal bowl down because footage has emerged of a mouse crawling over a potato salad at a Christchurch Countdown supermarket.
Well, that is horrible.
Oh, yeah. And it comes as the Dunedin South Countdown remains closed for monitoring after rats were caught in the store. Ugh. New Zealand Food Safety is investigating the Christchurch incident. Deputy Director General Vincent Arbuckle joins us now. Vincent, thanks for your time this morning. The footage is pretty unpleasant to look at. Should we just expect these days, though, that there are going to be pests inside a supermarket?
No, we should not expect that at all, Anna. That's totally unacceptable, and that's certainly Woolworths' view as well.
If you find one rat or one mouse, though, you have only just seen the tip of the iceberg, have you not? The very fact that you've seen it speaks to the fact you have a much larger problem scurrying behind the walls.
You certainly can't rule it out, so you need to investigate further to make sure that there isn't a wider population. We were on site yesterday at Eastgate, and we've begun our investigation working with Woolworths. They're obviously beginning to make sure that it's only a single mouse, but we're keeping an open mind as to whether that's a wider problem.
It seems like it might be a wider problem if you look at the fact that Dunedin store, owned by the same chain, found 13 rats.
Yes, those Dunedin certainly have had a considerable problem for a period of time, and Woolworths have done the right thing. They closed last Friday. They remain closed. They've done a large amount of trapping, and I think we just have to let that run for a while to make sure that they get on top of that problem and can prove to themselves and to us that they've really eradicated that population.
The customer who spotted the mouse in Christchurch, in their comments on social media, seemed aghast that the store didn't close. Is it your expectation that if a pest is seen in a store that it should close immediately?
Certainly that deli section, our expectation is that would have shut immediately. All that food should have been disposed of, and a thorough check made as to where that mouse was. But we're in the early stages of investigating that with Woolworths, and we'll get to the bottom of what actually happened.
Yeah, because from the comments it seems it didn't close, and so does this now become a two-tandem investigation? Not only do they have a pest problem, they have a pest management problem with the way that they do handle these issues when they come up.
Yes, look, we are looking at their systems and processes, which is what you'd naturally expect to look at. So these are two, we believe, separate incidents. They're concurrent in time. But we're looking at them from both from just how Woolworths are managing pest management generally and these two particular incidents.
Are you then expecting that now, because there have been two quite separate incidents in two quite separate places, that this is an opportunity, or perhaps this is the time where there needs to be a wider look at Woolworths' overall pest management, I guess, issues, or the way that it has that system set up? If there's two different stores in two different geographical areas with reasonably disgusting problems, that perhaps speaks to a wider issue?
Look, that certainly has to be looked at, Anna. We've had a series of conversations with Woolworths at their most senior levels. They are very concerned about this. I know that they'll be reviewing and looking closely at their own systems. We'll be overseeing that, and we may take some further action in terms of a sample of other stores to see how the process works and to assure consumers that the process is working as it should be.
Can you clarify for me who is actually responsible for making sure that supermarkets do have a pest management system in place and that they're sticking to it?
In the first instance, the operator, the Woolworths themselves, are responsible. We are the regulator, so we will check through an independent verifier. So each store is independently inspected or verified on a regular cycle to make sure that they have pest management systems in place. I know Woolworths You know, they engage Rentokil, a leading pest management company. So they are doing the right things in terms of how they approach the issue. Just want to make sure that the system is robust and thorough and is well integrated. You've got a large organisation with many stores, and it's sometimes challenging to make sure a system is deployed consistently and any incidents are reported up to management quickly.
And who will make sure those stores are safe to open again or can provide a safe level of food for customers going in and shopping? Is that something that you go in and check now before they reopen after going through?
Absolutely. We've had senior food compliance officers at both supermarkets on many occasions. Dunedin a number of occasions and over the weekend, and at Eastgate yesterday. We're working very closely with Woolworths on the situation in Dunedin South particularly, and that store will not reopen until both we and Woolworths are satisfied it's ready to do so. The investigation into Eastgate, it's at the early stages, but once again, we'll want to be satisfied that it's not a wider issue and that that Woolworths have learnt from the experience and the store has good processes in place.
Vincent Arbuckle from New Zealand Food Safety, thanks so much for your time this morning. I should just clarify, Woolworths declined an interview but sent us a statement saying they would like to apologise to customers for the incident and reassure customers that food safety remains a focus.
Here's the thing. So do they biff everything out from the deli and just dump it and give it a good...
I think he was saying should have happened when they saw the mouse.
The mouse.
But that didn't happen.
The mouse was quite cute, though, in all honesty, but it's the rats that paralyse me. I just sit there going... Ugh.
Food's expensive. That mouse was free.
That mouse, I just can't believe what we were seeing in
that
clip.
It was not cute, and it would have been pooing all over the place.
Yeah.
Oh, absolutely.
There'll be mice droppings all over the place, and if there's one, you can bet there'll be more.
Which is why I wonder...
It's just disgusting.
Do you go through every aisle of the supermarket? I don't know. How long do you close it for?
Until you're sure.
The easiest answer, Daniel, just never go back there.
Oh, rats and mice just give me the...
The fact that it's becoming frequent now...
13 rats in that other supermarket.
You just can't help but walk into a supermarket and start looking and scanning around to see if you see anything crawling.
So if anyone sees Daniel Faitawa crawling along the floor of the aisle of their local supermarket...
I'm on rat watch. That's what I'm...